becoming aware of your breath, allowing the breath to flow in and out, letting the breath be deep, relaxed, and even. Imagine following the breath inside, allowing your awareness to expand with the flow of the breath, as though you are moving with the breath into a vast ocean of light. Hey. Being aware of this ocean of light, it contains energy, love, wisdom, healing, and great divine power. It contains your higher self, your own divine soul. As you connect with this ocean of inner light, allow yourself to breathe it through your entire being. Feel yourself expanded as you connect with this part of you. In your mind's eye, imagine you can place your inner hands in prayer at your heart center and bow your head respectfully to your soul, acknowledging this great divine being. Silently in your mind, have the intention to connect with your soul and any past life, experience or pattern that relates to power. It may be a misuse or abuse of power towards you or by you in any number of lifetimes. It may be positive uses, constructive uses of power towards you or by you in any lifetime. Just notice what you feel to allow the healing to begin to flow at a subconscious level. Thank you. to whatever extent you need conscious awareness, it shall come. If you do receive visions or insights, don't judge. We learn through experience, positive and negative. It's all part of the divine experience. Imagine that you can perceive waves of light as the soul releases these old memories. Painful or damaged energy may be released as color or sound from within your inner world. Notice what comes up for you. If you feel guilt or fear of being punished, shame or anger, frustration or helplessness, you may even feel regret. Despair or grief. Allow these feelings to arise and be released. They are a sign that you are consciously letting go. You may see or sense that shackles that have held your soul are beginning to break. Self-imposed judgments or restraints on your use of power can fall away if you are prepared to forgive yourself, to forgive others, and to begin to trust that your soul can use power in a wise, constructive, and loving way. You become aware of your soul as containing a burning fire deep within its core, like a radiant sun. And into this fire, you are able to cast away whatever experiences, associations, definitions or judgments of power you have carried within you that no longer serve your highest growth. You can release into this fire any time you have fallen into error of believing that the divine power that is within you is about you or your ego. Imagine releasing any memory, conscious or unconscious, of such experiences or beliefs from your being now. Let the fire in the soul burn it. this happens, you step into right relationship with your own divine power, realizing it flows through you. You are a part of it, and it is a part of you, but it is not of you. It happens through you. Any energy that flows from the soul, including your divine power, at a soul level may ask you to set a boundary, to be firm, at other times to be gentle, to be forgiving, to be kind. Trust that your power will manifest according to your soul wisdom, and that you can trust. The more surrendered you are to the higher wisdom of your soul and how it chooses to express itself powerfully through you, the less attached you are to how it chooses to do so. The more you can trust. If you wish, and if you are holding on still to any past experiences in this or other lifetimes, conscious or unconscious, of an ambivalent or difficult relationship to power, you can choose to surrender it into the divine fire that burns eternally within your soul. Imagine that as the soul burns, it becomes vibrant and clear, more radiant and brightly glowing. Imagine that the soul appears before you as a beautiful lotus blossom with many petals of many colors. Colors that are fiery and bright, and colors that are soft, pastel and pale. Each color has its own beauty and purpose. Choose to perceive your soul with its magnificent array of color and energy. Imagine that behind this beautiful kaleidoscope of your own soul, there is a vast sun, the source of light, love, and power in this universe. And imagine this sun shining through the kaleidoscope of your soul, bringing it to life like sunlight through the most exquisite stained glass window. Allow that kaleidoscope to spin, to come to life, and to shine brightly, without restraint, without fear or judgment. Your job is not to judge, but to be, to allow the divine light that animates your soul to bring you to life that you may shine and fulfill your task upon the earth, to help all beings in your own unique way, beloved, for no two paths are exactly alike. Feeling the power of this soul that you are. Recognizing the power of the source that brings it to light and to life. Staying present and learning how to become more comfortable, more accepting, less fearful and less judgmental of this divine power that you are. Imagine surrendering your smaller sense of self into the divine fire. As you begin to realize you are truly a vast divine being, and this human body is but one cell of that vast divine being. Valuable, but just one piece of a far greater being. Without losing your awareness of the kaleidoscope of your soul and the vast light of the divine sun shining through it, allow your awareness to expand to include your body in the physical world, your hands and your feet, the air on your skin. And either staying in meditation to continue our journey together, or beginning to bring your awareness slowly back to the here and now. And in your own time, opening your eyes.